القسم الثاني هذا هو الدرس الآن إن شاء الله.
So now we're going to now the lesson which is now the second part of the index that we made.
ما هو القسم الثاني من أقسام هذا المتن المبارك على ما قسمنا؟
So what's the second part in the index of this book? He says that it can be divided into five parts.
The three matters, principles.
المشاعر الثلاث.
The three important principles or the three important matters.
هل المسائل الثلاث هي الأصول الثلاث؟
So are the three important principles, are they the three principles, the three questions of the grade?
لا.
No.
المسائل الثلاث غير الأصول الثلاث. الأصول الثلاث أخذنا. هي باختصار أسئلة القبر وتأتي بإذن الله تعالى. نعم.
So we've taken the three principles. Which are the questions in the grave? Who is your Lord? Who is this man, the Prophet? And what is your religion? However, the three matters, the Masail al Thalath, they're separate. I'm going to take that now.
طيب. قبل أن نبدأ في الدرس، لابد أن نعرف التوحيد. من يعرف تعريف التوحيد عند أهل السنة والجماعة؟
So before we
تعريف التوحيد شرعاً.
Before we go into today's lesson, we have to first understand the definition of التوحيد. So who amongst you knows the definition of At-Tawheed according to Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah?
Subhanallah. لو يسألك إنسان يقول أنت موحد ماذا تقول؟
So if a person was to ask you, are you موحد? A person of Tawheed, what would you say?
يقول ما هو التوحيد هذا الذي تدعي؟ عرف لي التوحيد.
So then if he said to you, okay, what is the Tawheed that you say you're upon?
كيف أكون موحد؟
How can I be a موحد؟ What would you say؟
إذا لا تعرف التوحيد وتدعى أنك موحد فأنت لست موحد.
So if you don't know the definition of توحيد and yet you're claiming that you're موحد, a person of توحيد, then it's not true statement that you're making.
نعم. فأخوانا هذا أهم ما عليك معرفة التوحيد.
So our brothers, the most important thing which is upon you is to know the meaning and the definition of
Tawheed.
If the Muslim isn't going to memorize or know the definition of Tawheed, then who's going to learn it? The disbeliever? So this is what we previously mentioned. Remember when the Sheikh was mentioning, if somebody comes to you and says, why should we study Tawheed? You say to that person, are you a Mawahid? Are you a person of Tawheed? He'll say yes. So then you say to him, okay, explain us what you mean by Tawheed. So it's important.
التوحيد شرعاً هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما اختص به من الربوبية والألوهية والأسماء والصفات. نعم.
So therefore the meaning of التوحيد according to the Sharia is to single out Allah in every single aspect or every single matter that is specific to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Whether that relates to Ar-Rububiyya or Uluhiyya or As-Sama wa As-Safat. And the Shaykh is going to explain these three terms. So who can repeat the definition of At-Tawheed according to Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah? Who can repeat it? Said, the rest of you don't know the meaning of At-Tawheed?
هل أنتم أهل التوحيد أو أهل الشرك؟ ونحن التوحيد. قال اشرحوا لنا أهل التوحيد.
If now a non-Muslim or a disbeliever comes into the masjid and he says to you, are you people of Tawheed or are you people of Shirk? And you say we're people of Tawheed. He then says to you, okay, explain to me a Tawheed. So you have to all know the meaning of a Tawheed.
نعم, ما يعني؟ التوحيد
شرعاً
إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما اختص به من الربوبية والألوهية والأسماء والصفات. نعم.
To single out Allah in everything which is specific to Him. In ربوبية and ألوهية and أسماء والصفات.
لابد أن نحفظ التعاريف كما ذكرها العلماء. ما نترك من التعريف شيء.
So we have to memorize the definitions of التوحيد just as the scholars have mentioned. It's not correct for us to leave bits of the definition out.
نعم. هذا معنى أن التوحيد ينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام: توحيد الربوبية والألوهية والأسماء والصفات.
So this is the meaning of when we say that Tawheed can be split into three categories, either Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, Uluhiyyah, and Asma al-Sifat. So as for Tawheed al-Rububiyyah,
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعاله.
It is to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in all of His actions.
أو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالخلق والملك والتدبير.
Or that we single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in that He is the one who is al-Rabb, i.e. the Lord. He is the one who is al-Khaliq, the Creator, and He is the only one who is Mudabbir al-Amr, that He controls all the affairs of the universe. This is Tawheed al-Rububiyyah.
توحيد الربوبية هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعاله أو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالخلق والملك والتدبير.
So again, just so you memorize, توحيد الربوبية is to single out Allah in all of His actions, or we can say, single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى that He is the only Rabb, the Lord, the only Khaliq, the Creator, or the one who controls the affairs of the universe.
الثاني توحيد الألوهية.
Secondly, توحيد الألوهية.
أو توحيد العبودية أو توحيد العبادة.
Or you can say توحيد العبودية. Or you can say توحيد العبادة. You can say any of these three things.
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالعبادة.
So this is to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in your worship.
أو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعال العباد.
Or to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in your actions of worship as a slave to Him.
الصلاة والصيام والحج والزكاة والرب والرهبة والخشوع كل العبادة لله.
So for example, prayer, الصلاة, fasting, Hajj, and also الرهبة, which is desiring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الرهبة, fearing Allah, Al-Khushu', humility, all of these are types of worship. And therefore we have to single them out purely for the sake of Allah.
تعريف توحيد الأسماء والصفات.
And then the definition of توحيد الأسماء والصفات.
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما سمى وصف به نفسه.
It is to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in every single name He has given Himself, or every single description or attribute or characteristic that He has given Himself.
في كتابه أو على لسان رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Either in his book al-Quran or upon the tongue of his messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وذلك بإثبات ما أثبت لنفسه. هذا أعطينا شو؟
mobile.
نعم.
We agree that nothing you hear, but if we see anybody playing with mobile, it gets taken. Anybody seen writing with a pen, the pen gets taken.
جزاك الله خير.
So he said توحيد الأسماء والصفات. It is
إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما سمى وصف به نفسه.
Is to single out Allah سبحانه وتعالى in everything, or in every name which He has named for Himself, or in every attribute which He has given to Himself.
في كتابه أو على لسان رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Either in the Quran or on the tongue of His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وذلك بإثبات ما أثبت لنفسه.
And that is by affirming everything which Allah affirmed for Himself. Or negating everything which Allah has negated from Himself. And that is without performing a tahrif. And the meaning of tahrif is to change the wording from what Allah has mentioned. Or a ta'til. And a ta'til means to negate the meaning or to interpret the meaning wrongly.
غير تحريف ولا تعطيل وغير تكييف ولا تمثيل.
And without forming a takif. And takif is
يسأل عن الكيفية كما قال الرحمن عرش استوى قال كيف استوى.
So the meaning of a takif is to question about the attributes. So for example, when Allah says in the Quran الرحمن على العرش استوى, Allah الرحمن the most merciful is established over His throne, a person would say, how is He established over His throne?
Now,
so you're questioning how is the attribute of Allah, and this is not allowed in Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat.
وَلَا تَمْثِيلِ.
And similarly at Tamthil, which is equating the attribute of Allah to the attribute of creation.
يعني تمثيل الله سبحانه وتعالى بخلقه.
So for example, equating Allah to His creation, even though Allah is more high and more elevated than His creation.
من يذكر لي تعريف التوحيد وتعريف أنواع التوحيد؟
So who can mention now from amongst you the definition of a Tawheed with Ahl Sunnah and the definition of the three categories of Tawheed according to Ahl Sunnah?
من يعلم؟
Who knows?
فقط بقي معه التوحيد.
Only three or four people. Nobody else knows the Tawheed.
من يدرس التوحيد إذا أهل الكفر؟
Who's going to study Tawheed? The people of disbelief.
إخوانا هذا أهم ما عليك. نحن الآن ندرس في الدورة هذه الدورة ما هو معلوم من الدين بالضرورة.
Said, our brothers, this is the most important thing that is an obligation for you to study. We're studying in this Dora, these lessons, that which should be known by necessity. The Shaykh isn't teaching something which is voluntary, something which is surplus to requirements. This is the biggest and most obligatory of types of knowledge upon you. So who can define a Tawheed according to the Sharia?
التوحيد شرع. لا حول ولا قوة. طيب. نعم.
إفراد الله باللباس.
مال التوحيد شرعا إفراد.
مال التوحيد شرعا إفراد الله باللباس والأفعال. والأفعال.
من يعرف للتوحيد شرعا؟ نعم.
توحيد شرعا إفراد الله بما يختص به
من
من عبادة
من
الربوبية
قلنا الربوبية وألوهية وأسماء وصفات
ما نتكلم
who gave the answer
Spain.
بسم الله تهضر
إفراد الله إفراد الله بالله بما اختص به من الربوبية والألوهية وبأسماء بأسماء والصفات
فتح الله عليك الذي يعني يوجه عليه السلام ويتكلم
شكرا
نعم
أريد أن أساعده
توحيد ما في مساعدة يسأل وحده في قبره
he said you can't help anybody about توحيد in the grave you'll be asked alone
نعم إذن التوحيد شرعا وإفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما اختص به من الربوبية والألوهية والأسماء والصفات.
So therefore, the Tawheed, according to the Sharia, is to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every single matter which is specific to Him. In His ربوبية, in Him, in His Tawheed, and ألوهية and أسماء وصفات.
من يعرف لي توحيد الربوبية؟
So who can define توحيد الربوبية؟
توحيد الربوبية. نعم.
Tawheed of Rububiyyah is singing Allah alone in His Lordship and everything that He's described for Himself. And
Tawheed
of singing Allah alone in His Lordship and everything that He's described to and they are making the thing basically.
إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعاله أو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالخلق والملك والتدبير.
To single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His actions, or we can say it's to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in being the creator and being the one who is the Lord al-Rabb or the one who controls the affairs. That's Tawheed al-Rububiyyah.
Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah.
Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah.
Or Tawheed al-Ibadah or Tawheed al-Ubudiyyah.
Or any of those three terms. Uluhiyyah or Ibadah or Ubudiyyah.
Na'am. Na'am. إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالعبادة أو بأفعال العباد.
It is to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship, or to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your actions of worship.
توحيد الأسماء والصفات.
توحيد الأسماء والصفات means attributes.
هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بما سمى وصف به نفسه في كتابه أو عن لسان رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
It is to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every name which he has given himself or every attribute which he has given himself either in the Quran or upon the tongue of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and that is by affirming everything which he has affirmed for himself and negating everything which he has negated away from himself that's without a tahrif i.e. changing the wording or a ta'atib i.e.
تخليه والترك تعطيل ماجب إثبات لله سبحانه وتعالى
I falsely interpreting the meanings of names and attributes of Allah or without a takif questioning how the attribute is or without tamthil, i.e. giving an example or quoting the attribute of Allah to the attribute of creation.
Yeah.